Hello guys, today we are going to start our next chapter, that's chapter number 3, and in our first slow of this chapter is the distribution of power with reference to the 1973 constitution. And this slow we will discuss that how the powers are distributed according to the 1973 constitution. You know guys, the constitution of 1973, it's a federal constitution, and it is the nature of federal constitution that according to the federal constitution, powers are divided between center and provinces. So since this is a federal constitution, so powers are clearly divided between center and provinces. Powers are originally divided into three lists, that are the federal list. In federal list, such subjects are included on which the federal government has the power to legislate, for example, defense, foreign policy, and finance. They are federal subjects, and it is the federal government which has the which is having the power to legislate on these subjects. So defense, foreign policy, and finance, on these subjects federal government can only legislate. And next is the provincial list. In provincial list, such subjects are included on which the province has the power to legislate. They are health, sanitation, and tourism. So on these subjects, health, sanitation, and tourism, only provincial assembly has the power, is having the power to legislate. So federal government cannot interfere in these matters. These are the subjects which are assigned to the provincial government. Only provincial government has authority to legislate on these issues. And the third is concurrent list. On concurrent list, such subjects are included on which federal government and the provincial government together legislate. For example, if a subject is included in concurrent list, on that subject, federal government and the respective province can legislate, they can legislate together. For example, let's take an example, and that's the minerals. It was in concurrent list before 18th amendment. On minerals, the federal government and the provincial government can legislate together. Only federal government or only provincial government could not legislate on that subject. So now this concurrent list is abolished and mostly it's transferred to the provincial list. So after 18th amendment, practically we are having only two lists, that are federal list and provincial list. Thank you for joining. Take care. Goodbye.